Hi, today we're going to be learning about the phylum Cnidaria, which includes animals like corals, sea anemones, and jellyfish. This video is going to be focusing on the class Hydrozoa, which include colonial siphonophores such as the Portuguese Man-of-War, and smaller organisms such as hydras. Now it's time to learn a little bit more about the features and morphology of hydroids. For this exercise, we are going to be comparing thecate, hydroids with a theca covering, and athecate, hydroids without a theca covering. We are going to be basing these drawings on two species, Obelia and Garveia. The features both hydroids have in common are the gastrozoid, which functions as the feeding zoid, the gonozoid, used for reproduction, mouth, and tentacles. For the thecate drawing, you will also be labeling the hydrotheca and the perisarch. Both of these are protective coverings for different parts of the hydroid, and annuli, which are rings on the stalk. Here are pictures of our two species in their natural habitats. On the left is Obelia, and on the right is Garveia. Examine these photos and try to sketch what they look like, paying extra attention to the features we just talked about. Can you identify the two different zooids and the theca covering that characterizes Obelia? Now that you've had a chance to try it on your own, let's draw them together. Hydroids are usually found attached to some kind of substrate. We can start by drawing the branch stalks of the hydroid and then labeling the outer features. The gonozoid contains reproductive organs and lacks tentacles. The gastrozoid is the feeding zoid. The surrounding theca offers a protective shell so the hydroid can retract when faced with a disturbance. Here is an inside view of a retracted gastrozoid. Think about what kinds of advantages having a theca might give the hydroid. Again, attached to a substrate, the athecate hydroid lacks a theca covering, but are otherwise very similar to thecate hydroids. In this case, the gonozoids are bulb-like extrusions on the stalk, and the gastrozoids have their tentacles open to the environment. You can imagine a close-up of an open gastrozoid with its tentacles outstretched around the mouth to catch food particles. Thanks for watching, and I hope that you'll tune in to our next episode of Ocean Inverts.